Gildan Media presents Your Coach in a Box, affordable, life-changing audio programs.
Gildan Media presents Endless Ambition, How to Wake Up Fired Up by David J. Lieberman, Ph.D. Read by Grover Gardner. If I ask, what's one objective you have in your career, most people will respond, I want to make a lot of money. But if I then ask, what's a lot of money, I will get hundreds of different answers. If you want to lose weight as part of your physical area, you'd probably have, I want to lose weight on your list of goals, right? But what exactly does that mean in your particular situation? 5 pounds? 20? 100? If, on the other hand, you ask yourself the question, what do I want specifically, you will get a more specific answer, and your brain will have a clear goal to shoot for. Key number one, know what you want specifically. In order to feel ambitious, or for that matter, to achieve anything, you have to know what you want specifically. That's the first key. You see, the brain can only give us what we tell it we want. It cannot work on vague instructions. Have you ever gone shopping for something without a clear idea of what you were looking for? You know you need a new CD player or a new pair of shoes, but you haven't thought about what features you want the CD player to have, or what kind of shoes will fit best into your wardrobe. When you go shopping like that, you end up with one of two results. One, you buy whatever strikes your fancy at the moment, whether it meets your needs or not. And often, when you get your purchase home, you find the shoes don't match the suit you were planning to wear them with, or the CD player doesn't work with one of the components of your audio system. The second result is equally frustrating. You waste a lot of time wandering around from store to store looking at all kinds of CD players or shoes. You are unable to make up your mind because you don't know what you want, and you end up coming home with nothing. Is that how you want to pursue the goals and objectives of your life? Why do you think 99% of all New Year's resolutions don't work? They're usually so darn vague, that's why. Every New Year's resolution starts the same way. I will start an exercise program. I will lose weight. I will get a better job. I will be more kind to my friends. I will save money. And people never accomplish them because they are completely unspecific. There's nothing for your brain to hold on to. All a New Year's resolution does is get you excited for a day because you feel that you're going in the right direction. Unfortunately, you have no idea of how to get there because you don't know specifically what you want. Let's take the example of losing weight. This is something almost everyone has as a goal at some time, right? And most people can lose weight with a little effort and a little discipline. Yet how many of us fail to achieve this simple objective? Why? Because losing weight is too vague. Our brain has nothing to focus on. We're shopping for the CD player without knowing what features we want. If we tell our brain, I want to lose weight, and then go out and jog for a half a mile one day and lose a half of 1 pound, we've accomplished our objective, right? Even if we're 100 pounds overweight, we've done what we said we wanted to do. We lost weight. Now, was losing 1/2 pound our true objective? Probably not. But without a more specific goal, our brain won't support us in going out and jogging every day. If it's raining or too hot or an important appointment comes up, our brain won't insist that we go jogging no matter what. It'll tell us, it's okay, you can skip a day, or this is more important than jogging, or you're on the right track, so don't worry. And that's why most people fail to lose weight. Flabby goals produce flabby results and lead to flabby people. Vague instructions equal vague results. The mind needs something specific to focus on. It is literally impossible to keep your focus strong if your objective is vague. You have to be able to see and feel what it is you're looking for. So you can't just say, I want to have a better body, or I want to make more money, or I want a better career. You must tell yourself what specifically it is you're looking for. Any instruction you give yourself must be as specific as you can possibly make it. Unfortunately, it's much easier to write down something abstract, general, and vague than it is to write down something meaningful and specific. It's a lot easier to say, I want a better job, than it is to decide exactly what job you're looking for. It's a lot easier to say, I want to be in great shape, than to decide exactly what that means to you. After all, your definition of being in great shape is probably different from someone who wants to become a professional bodybuilder, or a grandmother with arthritis, or a 13-year-old gymnast, to give you just a few examples. But if you take the time to get really specific about what exactly you want, you will find it a whole lot easier to achieve your goals. You will be giving your brain something concrete to aim for, a vision with so many details that it will seem completely real and achievable. Kind of like when Dorothy and her companions actually saw the Emerald City for the first time in the movie The Wizard of Oz. Even though it was in the distance, the sight of the tall green towers and the walls sparkling in the sun was so exciting that everyone started running toward their destination. That's what a specific goal can do for you, literally pull you forward with excitement. So, are you ready to get really, really specific about your goals? Great! There are three simple steps in this process. Take out your list of your 12-month goals and objectives, and pick one that you really want to achieve, but which is a little, or really, vague. On a clean sheet of paper or a fresh page in your journal, write that goal at the top of the page. Step 1. Make it complete. Now, take a look at that goal and ask yourself question number 1. What does that mean specifically? If your goal is to lose weight, what specifically does that mean to you? If you want a better job, what do you mean by a better job? And once you've answered the question, what does that mean specifically, take a look at your answer, and then ask question number 2. And then what? Or what else about? Keep asking question number 2 until you get all the possible details about that goal or objective. Keep going until the goal is clear, specific, fully detailed, and compelling. Let me show you how this works. My friend Joe met me for lunch one day and told me he wanted a better job. So I asked him, what does a better job mean to you specifically? Joe said, a job in the advertising industry. Great, and then what? What else about that job? One where I can manage my own accounts. Great, what else? A salary that's $10,000 more than I'm making right now. What else? Input both on the creative side and the business side. Great, what else? I want to work at a big agency where there's lots of room for advancement and recognition for the people who work hard and do good work. Great, and then what? It should be in the city.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.